Good evening, everyone. I'm Jovita Moore.
I'm Justin Farmer, and that chaos caught on camera happened during a Republican rally at a well-known pumpkin farm in Dawsonville.
What is your name? What is your name? What is your name? Sir, what is your name?
New at 6, Channel 2's Lori Geary talked with the citizen journalist who says she was just recording video of the event. And then there's the sheriff who says his captain's actions were absolutely warranted. Lori is live in the newsroom.
Nydia Tisdale, who's out on bond on a felony charge, says this was a public event on private property and she had the owner's permission to be there. She says the candidates like Governor Nathan Deal and Labor Commissioner Mark Butler had no problem with her videotaping the event, but accuses a Dawson County sheriff's captain of abusing his authority.
We really appreciate having you here at Burt's Farm.
This is video taken by self-described citizen journalist Nydia Tisdale at a Republican rally at Burt's Farm in Dawson County. She was about to find out neither she nor her camera were welcome.
What is your name? Let go of me! What is your name, sir? Let go of me! I spoke with the owner prior to this event.
I didn't know who approached me. There are three different men who were unidentified, unnamed, filming, and so I'm not turning my head to get a good look at him because I'm trying to record the speaker.
Tisdale's camera is still rolling as she is escorted out of the event. She says she had no idea the person who pulled her arm behind her and pushed her against a table was a Dawson County deputy.
He slams me up against the countertop and bends me over and pushes his body up against mine.
I've been real nice. Now you're going to jail for resisting arrest.
Okay, I'll leave.
No, you're leaving. Now you're going to jail. You've resisted me, my lawful duties, trying to get you to cooperate.
At one point, the chairwoman of the Dawson County GOP states her objections to the way Tisdale is being treated and storms off.
This is wrong.
According to the Sheriff's Department report that we obtained, Tisdale was eventually handcuffed and taken from Burt's Farm here to the Dawson County Jail. She was charged with criminal trespassing and felony obstruction of an officer. Tisdale was released on a more than $6,000 bond.
When she refused to leave, an officer wouldn't started escorting her away from the property, and that's when she started struggling and struck Officer Wooten in the shin and in the jaw, and that became obstruction of officer at that time.
Dawson County Sheriff Billy Carlisle told me he was shocked by the video, so he suspended Captain Tony Wooten for 2 days with pay and did his own internal investigation. He says Wooten's actions were justified and there was probable cause for arrest.
I've got a camera. It's not a gun. It's not a knife. It's not a sword, it's just a camera.
We tried to talk to Johnny and Kathy Burt, but their employees told us they weren't available because they were working in the fields. Tisdale's attorney told me they plan to sue Burt's Farm and also the Dawson County Sheriff's Department. Reporting live from the newsroom, Lori Geary, Channel 2 Action News.
Well, there's a lot of emotion going on there. There's no question about that. So what do you think? We've posted that video of the citizen journalist being dragged out of a political rally on our Facebook page. Comment on it by going to facebook.com/WSBTV.